Before this video starts, I just want to point out that 90% of you guys aren't subscribed. So, bruh, what are you doing? Subscribe, because I post new videos just like this one every single week. Anyways, enjoy the video. Peace. At number 5 on the underrated list is my personal favorite roller coaster in Texas, and that is New Texas Giant at Six Flags Over Texas. I'll just let you guys get your screams out real quick. New Texas Giant has some of the best airtime that I have ever experienced on any RMC. Yes, I said it. I think that the drop is maybe even better than Iron Rattler's drop. And overall, the ride just packs in airtime hill after airtime hill after airtime hill, every single one giving you that awesome stomach feeling that you get. On top of all of that, the ride is pretty long and super, super rewritable, making me just want to get in line and ride it over and over and over again. It's really the only reason that I go to Six Flags Over Texas, because other than that, the park kind of sucks. Number 5 on the overrated list is another ride that a lot of people are going to get mad about, and that is Mako at SeaWorld Orlando. Mako is great. Do not get me wrong, but it is nowhere near the level that I thought it was. I thought it was going to be one of my favorite roller coasters, but it doesn't even crack the top 10, maybe even not the top 15. In fact, I have Apollo's Chariot, the only other B&M Hyper that I've ridden, over Mako, just because Mako doesn't really give you that stomach feeling that I love on B&M Hypers. Mako has this weird mix from floater to ejector airtime that's not strong enough to be flow-jector and sustained, but also not weak enough to give you that floater feeling. So it's just kind of there. I don't really know how to explain it. Overall, it was weird, it disappointed me, but it is still a super rewritable ride, so that's why it's not like at number 1 on this list. Number 4 on the underrated list is one of the only why it's the best videos that I actually agreed with the point that I was arguing in it, and that is Gatekeeper at Cedar Point. Gatekeeper is awesome, okay? It's super graceful, but also kind of forceful in some moments. Those vest restraints I actually love on this ride because it makes you feel super comfortable as you're getting amazing hang time going through those keyhole elements and really just on every other element of this ride. My personal favorite row is actually the front row on the right side because you kind of get dipped down under on that wing over drop. And that feeling is unmatched. It's great. Overall, I don't know why people don't like this ride. Personally, it's my number 3 at the park. Yes, guys, it's over Maverick. Number 4 on my overrated list is Twisted Timbers at King's Dominion. I really do not like this ride. I used to, but now, no. Believe it or not, this used to be my favorite roller coaster back in like 2018 whenever I rode it for the first time. But after that, I think it's because my legs got longer, those restraints just kept bothering me more and more and more, and now the coaster is straight up painful. The first half is amazing. That barrel roll drop is great. It's an experience that is really unmatched from any other coaster. But that second half just slams you up into the restraints, forward into the shin guards, and it's just not a very comfortable experience that honestly, a lot of the times just has me wanting the coaster to end. I cannot see at all how someone would have this over Intimidator 305. In fact, I don't even have it over Dominator. Number 3 on my underrated list is my favorite roller coaster in Florida, Cheetah Hunt at... Oh my god, I can just imagine all of the like Kumba and Montu fans screaming in their rooms. Okay, I can get through this. My number three underrated coaster is Cheetah Hunt at Busch Gardens Tampa Bay in Tampa, Florida. This ride is awesome, okay? It has amazing airtime, the launches are pretty forceful, the restraints did not bother me as much as the Maverick and I-305 restraints did, which are kind of interesting because I know that most people feel the complete opposite way. But overall, I love the gracefulness of that ride, the airtime, and just the whole experience is really unique on a coaster, at least from the coasters that I've ridden. And that is why it ranks so highly in my list of top coasters. Number three on my overrated list is a ride that either you love or you hate. And I kind of go towards the hate side, and that is Magnum XL 200 at Cedar Point. I've heard a lot of people say that this is the best coaster at Cedar Point, and for me, it doesn't even make the top 10. This ride is boring, it's painful, and just overall, I do not get the hype. I rode it once, and I was satisfied with that. Of course, if I go back to Cedar Point, I will 100% give it another chance just to see if I maybe sat in the wrong seat, because I did sit towards the back and not in the magic seat. So I'll do that, and most likely, honestly, it won't be that much better. Hear that, Dom? Magnum is not that good. At number two on my underrated list is a coaster that I mentioned a little bit earlier when talking about one that was on the overrated list, and that is Apollo's Chariot at Busch Gardens Williamsburg. Apollo's Chariot is amazing. It has three amazing airtime moments, and that is the first drop, the drop off of the mid-course brake run, and the final drop before it hits the brake run. All of these three elements really give amazing floater airtime that give you that stomach feeling every single time I ride. Whoa. Oh, my camera setup is falling. Overall, Apollo's Chariot is an elite hyper, and no one can tell me differently. At number two on my overrated list is another coaster that I did talk about a little bit earlier when talking about Silver Bullet, and that is Montu at Busch Gardens Tampa Bay. Montu is just not that great. It's really shaky, kind of rough in some spots, definitely gives you a little bit of head banging. It is forceful, but that's not really something that I enjoy in most coasters, especially B&M inverts. I like them to be more graceful. So overall, I would say that a big part of why I don't like Montu is just because it's not my type of ride. At the number one spot for my most underrated roller coasters that I've ridden is Screamin' Eagle. I'm imagining some people are going like, what's Screamin' Eagle? Screamin' Eagle is an amazing wooden roller coaster at Six Flags St. Louis that cracked my top 10 coasters that I've ridden. The ride is really bumpy, but it kind of adds a lot to the ride because every time you're about to go up into an airtime hill, it bumps you up, and then the airtime hill just makes the car disappear from under you, so you're kind of floating up there for multiple seconds at a time. Every single hill on that ride gives you that amazing stomach feeling, and there are tons of hills. It really does feel like the ride is not gonna end. It's definitely a ride that I try to ride as many times as possible every time I go to Six Flags St. Louis, and it's definitely a ride that you guys should give another chance if you didn't really pay attention to it whenever you rode it. And finally, number one on my most overrated roller coasters that I've ridden, that is Raptor at Cedar Point, no question. Raptor, not only is it not very good, it sucks. It's my number two least favorite roller coaster that I have ridden. The headbanging is absolutely terrible, probably worse than all of the aero loopers combined. It left me with a headache after I got on it, which is kind of rare. Most coasters don't really leave me with headaches that often. And no, I did not ride towards the back. I actually rode in the front row. So why was it so rough? The headbanging was so bad that I don't remember any of the layout. All I remember is my vision being blurred as my head was just swinging from side to side to side on the restraints. It was terrible. And of course, the worst part was that ending transition into the brake run, no question. And there you go. Those are my top 10 most overrated and most underrated roller coasters that I've ridden. What are yours? Comment down below if you have any disagreements from coasters that I've mentioned on this list. I know that most of you guys probably do. Also, before I go, I just want to get this out of the way. To anyone who thinks that Boomerang is the best roller coaster at Six Flags Fiesta Texas, I think that there is something wrong with your head. Okay? Okay, Kevin? Okay. Actually, now that I'm thinking about it, probably the thing that's wrong with your head is that you rode Boomerang so many times and you banged your head so much, so now you've gone crazy. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I hope that you enjoyed. If you did, make sure to smash that thumbs up button. Also, did you like this concept of video? Let me know, because I will definitely make more, especially because I'm working a lot more, so I have less time to go to the park. I may start making more ranking or other types of videos along those lines to fill in the gaps. Also, don't forget to subscribe, because I try my best to upload every single week. Anyways, until next time, peace out.